That's the best space quality video I think we've ever had. All right, she helps people get that new and improved body they'd always hoped for. We're talking about the new season of Dr. 90210. It's Dr. Kat. Dr. Kat, good morning. How are you?
Good morning. I'm fantastic. Thanks for having me on.
We're very happy to have you on. We'll have you play the piano behind you a little later. But let me ask you this. Increasingly, I would imagine, more and more patients are men, but very few men are in this profession, the specific profession that you're in. The statistic they're telling me, only 15% of all plastic surgeons are women. Why do you think that is?
I mean, it's for a variety of reasons. I mean, I think traditionally plastic surgery has just been a very male-dominated field. I know that when I first came into practice over 10 years ago, it was actually less than 10%. But it is a very demanding job. The training is very long. Like I was in my, you know, plastic surgery training for over 16 years. So I think a combination of it being demanding and also taking a long time, I think. And I think that for me, during the time that I did my training, it wasn't traditionally a female specialty of medicine. So I think that's one of the things that we're hoping to change with this new show, Dr. 90210, to show young girls and women out there that, you know, women can also be surgeons and also just to provide a different look, you know, to break down those stereotypes of what a Beverly Hills plastic surgeon should be like.
And to that end, is there a particular doctor that is best suited for the breast, a particular doctor that is best suited for the tummy tuck, a particular doctor that's best suited for the chin lift? Are there these narrow specializations?
Yeah, I mean, I think that we're trained broadly in all aspects of plastic surgery, and we all practice that in our own practices. But there are specific specialties that each one of us focus on, and I think that's highlighted a lot in the show. So myself in particular, I specialize in mommy makeovers. I do a lot of body contouring and also vaginal cosmetic surgery, which is something you may not have heard of before.
No, I know that's a relatively new topic. And I think people thought that that area was, impervious is the wrong word, but that area was not plastic surgery-able, but you're saying it is.
Plastic surgery. I mean, yes. I mean, it's a part of the body just like anything else. And I think one of the things that I've really tried to do, especially on my social media, is just have this open conversation where women can feel free to have discussions about any part of their body without feeling any shame or feeling discouraged. So that's sort of why I say I'm a pioneer when it comes to vaginal cosmetic surgery, just so, you know, if a woman is trying to find something or make a physical change in order to feel better, to feel more confident and also comfortable physically, they know that there are resources out there for that.
All right, we're going to travel a little north of the body to the tummy area.
Sure.
Here's a clip from Dr. 90210.
So basically, like, my whole belly, there's a lot of fat.
Do me a favor, I'll do this exercise with me. So stretch your stomach skin up. Perfect. Okay. So see what I'm pinching here?
Yes.
Like that tiny little bit that's only like about 2 centimeters or so, that's your fat pinch. Like the rest is skin. Like see all this movement? It's just skin. As a mom, I can totally relate to some of the body issues that Ashley is having. After my pregnancy, I remember finding fat pockets in places I didn't even know I had fat before.
The only way to tighten the skin would be to do a tummy tuck.
All right, Dr. Kat, we'll find out what she does. Thanks so much for talking with us this morning. We'll tell folks that Dr. 90210 airs Mondays at 10. It is on E. Frank and Jessica, back to the two of you.
I like how you tried to word those questions.
Thank
Very
you.
Delicately, Sam.
I was doing the best.
Nicely done.